Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode here on our single player world. Today, I have actually not done too much in between these past two episodes. A lot of you guys mentioned you really like the color of the water in the thumbnail. Now, I haven't actually thought about changing water in anything, to be completely honest. I don't even have a texture pack on. I'm not a big fan of changing textures. The sky, of course, is the only one that we do have on here, but I don't know, we'll have a look into that. I did kind of like the look of that water, but although, you know what, like, it's still very Minecrafty to just go with whatever's default on here. I've just realized we don't have that on. There we go. That's much better. All right. So first of all, before we go any further, last episode, I claimed something for myself, which really shouldn't have been claimed for myself. I mentioned something about some of those little fishermen's, well, the fisherman's house that I wanted to build there. That was not my idea, despite the fact that I did think it was. You know what happened? I must have read comments and thought, hey, that sounds like a great idea, without even realizing it. And, it was actually a comment, like, almost word for word. So, apologies. And, of course, we're going to be building them today. Because that's what the title should say, something along those lines. And what we're going to do is probably do a little bit of a setup over here. I've got all this stuff on me. What's a good spot? Maybe around here somewhere. Like here. Oh, that path can actually connect down to there. Fantastic. Alright, so we need to get out these things here, which I've packed away. Like a good person would. We'll do that, that, and those over there. Cool. Alright, we need to get ourselves... Oh, by the way, I chopped down... I chopped down a bunch of oak as well. And spruce as well. We should be pretty good on all these things. I want to get some of those. And maybe actually some of those as well. Those. And those. They'll be good. Maybe even these. And yeah. they'll be alright. In fact, we don't need three of those. We only need one. That we'll need. That comes in handy. Okay, tell you what. I think we're looking pretty good for what I wanted to get out here. We'll stop at that. So, what I want to do here, with this plan, let's actually fly over this way for these things. I want to have a little bit of, not really a community, but like just a little bit of a fishing thing going on here. We'll have probably one little thing going out here, one little dock thing, jetty coming out here. And we'll have a little bit of a, like, pathway over there with maybe one house facing this way, one house there, another house right next to it there, built into the... land, as I said. So, let's check if we can get this right. No, we can't. Whoa. Never happens that good when I try. Okay, so, that should be alright. Now, the first thing that I think I want to do is mark out how wide I want these to be. And a little bit of something that I want to try here is something which I've been experimenting with for actually quite a bit of time now. And that is the fact that I build houses with a bit of depth. With some rules that I didn't realize I had. So maybe we'll just do this here. And we'll mark that out. How far out do we want to come? Yeah, probably around here, actually. Alright. So what I was saying is I have a lot of weird rules that I don't realize I follow whenever I'm making houses. So we'll go out here a little bit. And one of those is obviously odd numbers, which are things that I think... are important to build in to make your houses look a little bit better. I will stand by that. That's something I probably wouldn't change. Oh, man. Really? but yeah, that's something I wouldn't change. But something that I want to try out is another rule, which this one's kind of just one that I came across, obviously, in, like, developing phase and of me trying to develop how I'm going to be building and all that sort of stuff. And it's kind of just stuck. Just purely because everything here follows that rule. But now that we're a little bit out of that area there, I don't think it'll look too weird to change that rule up a bit. And what that is I tend to build very, like, my depth in my builds tends to be based around about one block depth. And you'll see what I mean when I show you now what I'm talking about. When I make my houses normally, I would normally, for instance... Let's just clear out a bunch of land here. We'll just rebuild this around there. Alright. So, when I build my houses, let's say, for instance, I built a wall, and in fact, we're going to build the wall right here now. So we'll build the wall in here with some of these. Get rid of those. All right. So we'll build this wall in... thinking about here will be good. Like that, right? And we'll go up a few blocks, and I'll show you what I'm talking about here. So if we do this, like that there, I tend to do stuff along these lines here, and I'm not too sure how wide we've just gone there. Let's just count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Perfect number that I wanted. That's great. All right, so we'll get rid of these here, and you'll see, I normally would go out here, there, one block. You see this? This is as far out as I'll go. Go here, out one block, and that gives us that element of depth in this build, which I enjoy. I enjoy having a certain amount of depth in the build. But what I've been practicing, well, testing out over... this actually came shortly after we started this, where I started playing around with this, and I thought I would want to give it a go in here at some stage, is pulling this out even further. So, for instance, pulling this out one more, up to here or so, and... how can I not pick that up? Let's get rid of that. And maybe pulling this out here. And now giving it a go to try and create a bit extra of extra depth. So this gives us the ability to really, for instance, let's say, let's just pretend this was a wind, like a normal wall without anything on it. We could do, for instance, something along these lines here, like this. Say there was more wall back there. We could do something like that. And I haven't actually practiced what I'll do here, but, I mean, it could be something along these lines. Going up here, and say, as I say, we weren't putting a door on here, and that these are actually these, right? There. Perfect. We could easily make a window with some extra depth in it. We could push out like this, or, I mean... that's a bit low. That's just a little bit of a pain with the fact that we're doing half like these types of blocks. But you see how we could do that, for instance, and knock out a window here. And then still have a lot of room to create, for instance, something along these lines like this or something. I don't know. Maybe something like that. I don't know. Just something like that. Where we could have a spot to have a window with stuff like that. And still have this, still pushing out another block of depth. Which I think will probably in the future be the way we go in terms of making a lot of our projects work the way we want them to work. But I just thought I'd share that with you guys, because that's something I've been thinking about for quite a bit of time of like what I want to do in terms of building with this stuff. So that's just something going through my head. Now, with this build, we're going to get into this build, and we're going to do this, as I said. But what I'm thinking is we want this to be a little bit higher than what it is right now. Because the logic is, if you're living in this water place, you really don't want water coming into your house. So probably putting in a little bit of a step up and building it one up would be a good idea. And we'll just place those in there. There we go. And I'm probably going to actually change this wall just purely because our ground is a separate color. Probably going to change this wall over to an oak log versus one of these, oak planks instead of these spruce planks, because they obviously just clash a bit too much. Well, don't clash enough. So what I might do is I'll just get in this first house with a bit of messing around on that. I'm also probably going to end up doing a little bit of a roof or something on it, and then we can have a look at the other two that I want to build and see what we're going to do, if we're going to do the same sort of thing with them, or if we're going to change it up, or just see how our current test is going. You know what I mean? See if maybe we want to fix everything and change everything. Whoa. Alright, so this is what I've come up with here. I don't know whether it works just yet, but it's definitely something a bit different. There's a little bit of extra gap here. I want to still do something in here. Maybe we can do something along the lines of a bit of stone or something like that. We'll actually get to that in the future. But what we're going to do now is we're going to probably just finish off the front entrance of this. And by the way, I've also extended this around this way, so we've got... got that there, and I'm probably just going to extend it actually around here as well before I forget. Let's do that, and then we can always make a little bit of a path up that way, like kind of a crude path going up to where that path leads. So what I wanted to do here was I wanted to put in some windows, and normally I go for the spruce on the tops and bottoms, but actually I'm thinking oak could be a good thing to try here. Let's see how man how this looks. Yeah, that's not too bad. I feel like this bottom piece here should not be a bone block, though. Probably use something like these two. For now, we'll just use a bit of both of these. We'll get better stuff in later. Okay. Good. And now the next thing that I wanted to do, obviously we'll put in some blue windows there. Kind of feel like that piece there is missing something. Like a little bit of a support beam or something. We'll have to have a look at that. But yes. Oh, we can use these for something. That's them right there. In fact, how do these look as windows? Nope, not enough color to, not enough contrast there. Right, so actually, you know what could work is this. No. It can't, because this is not one of those types of windows. Man, this is tough. Alright, maybe we'll get back to that. But yeah, with some things, I want to quickly update you on some of the stuff that has happened. I've obviously done the main outer building of this, and we're obviously going to dig this away at some stage. But one trouble that I've just discovered is, that's a bit higher than that area there. And I wanted it to really go into the thing, but I'm not too upset with it. I think it could work that way, to be honest. And looking at it from where we just looked at it, I think it actually does work quite well. Let's have another. I think that does. Do I have a bed up here? I do. Great. Oh, this is that, like, unfinishable room. okay, so let's just head out of here before eyes hurt anymore. Okay, let's see. That actually looks kind of cool. I love having stuff to look out at now. Yeah, that does look actually pretty cool. Maybe what we could do is we could work our path up here first before we go on to these other two. So if we just go for a little bit of a simple path here. Maybe on the step-ups, what we'll do is we'll do... Just get rid of this. Here we go. Okay, so we want that path there. Get away from me. That noise will drive me crazy. Yeah, so this little path here, we'll continue this on. Over here. In fact, this is probably a perfect spot to step up like that. And we'll put these both as those. And then down here, this is where we're going to put our steps going down. We'll have to just do something like this. Now, what I'm doing, by the way, with this, because I'm wanting this to look more like a kind of semi-man-made path, you know what I mean? But not really. I want it to just still look quite natural. And the way we're doing that is we are putting in some of... Get out of here. We're putting these things into the ground. So, look at this. When I put these here and here, what that's really looking like, it's looking as though I have... Like, this has been part of the ground. Oh, man, we're going to have to do some of these things. There. There. No. Really? Cool. So, we'll do that there. We'll do the same over here. We'll just kind of put those away. Add in those. Those there. Add in those. And the reason what I was saying now with doing this into the ground like this, with these two in between things, is it kind of makes it feel like it's part of the ground versus coming out of the ground. You'll see what I mean when I'm finished. So when we do something like this, I'm getting a lot of, see that? Getting a lot of glitches in this area, like visual glitches. You see that? Very strange. But yeah, what I was saying is over here, like that, into the ground. It makes it look as if it's part of the ground, which kind of is the look we're going for. As though you're walking up here, it's all just kind of part of this path, and you walk around here, just like that. You know what I mean? I think that kind of works. So we'll go down here a bit more. Do it. Oh, this next one's going to be interesting because we don't really have enough space for it. What we could do is maybe just put in some of these now. It's like a little bit more steep and see how this looks. Yeah, that could work there. Alright, so we'll do that, and we will remove these here. And then we'll place these in here. In fact, we didn't even need to do what I just did there. So, there. There we go. That's alright. I think that'll look good. I think we just finish these off and not forget about them. But I think overall, that path will look a lot better than what I thought it would, to be honest. Let's just do that there, that there. And now as we walk down, does that feel all right? I think maybe just a bit on there. Yep. Yeah, cool. All right, so we'll have to put in some bushes and stuff over there to make it feel a bit more homely, I guess. And we'll get rid of that there, make that right level. That there, make that the right level. And now what we'll do is we'll get onto these two houses. So these two, I'm planning on maybe being a little bit smaller. What do we have? Gap here. There's a spider in here somewhere. You know what? Let's just make this a lot easier. There we go. Easy. So we'll place these in, and let's get going with a bit of planning on these. So we've got space for 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that 4 gap? And then 4 gap. Maybe. So if we know that over there, let's just measure out 7. So we do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, which means that there would be the middle. Is that right? So, well, 3 and 3. Yep, that's good. Beautiful. And then we'll go on this same one and see if we can get 7 out. If not, we'll have to go for 5, which isn't too much of a problem, but I would prefer 7. So let's just do this here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think this pillar would have to be in here. Like that. Yeah, that works out all right. And we can just maybe have a bit of a rock face or something over there. That'll work out all right. In fact, let me just count. I feel like I've done one too many here. So we'll get those. Oh, we've got... Ow, man, I'm being silly. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that is... That's the middle there. That's the middle there. Okay. Just, they felt different shaped. So we'll do that there. And these houses here, I'm planning on sharing a central pillar. So what I think, now that I've got this planning done for these, I'll put in the roof. And I'm doing a similar, actually, if you didn't have a look before, done a similar sort of style to what we normally do. But because we put these ones in here, they kind of pull in a little bit. And I kind of like that. You see what I mean? Just how it's got this weird sort of shape going onto it, as if it's been made like that purposefully. Which was actually completely a mistake, but I kind of like it. You know, it's a little bit more character, I guess, to it. So we'll do this for another little bit, I think. So we'll put those in, and I'll probably put the wall in. All right, so I finished them off, and I wanted to just kind of go over here. I like looking at stuff in this time of day on this texture pack. Look at that. Let's have a look. Yeah, that's looking good. They're looking pretty good, I think. I kind of don't 100% like the white from the bone block, so we might change that up to some extent. Maybe, you know what could actually work? Let's give this a try. Let's get some of those. Instead of having the bone block at the bottom, why don't we try putting in a bit of this? And I know this could look kind of weird because it'll be like these pieces are the same as the rest of the color, which means we could change it. We can just see how it looks. I'm sure that's no real harm. So we'll do that. There. There. And there. Let's have a look. Alright, so how does that look now? Yeah, I kind of don't mind that. Although, what could be something... Because I feel like it's also a little bit empty. Actually, I think we will go with the oak. But what I want to do is maybe get rid of that. And that. And then go with one of these up here until there. Try this out. So if we do that up to there, which will also give the top bit a bit of extra structure as well. Which could look quite good. Let's see that. No. Come on. There we go. Yeah, that top piece looks a bit funny now. I don't know. I think what I might do is I might leave that bottom. I don't know if I will leave that bottom piece. Yeah, I think I might leave the bottom actually, and I'll get rid of that top piece, and we can maybe put in a bit of that spruce fence just on the top there to fill up that area there. We may as well just get rid of the gnice and give it a go now. All right, guys, so I've kind of finished this off, and I want to quickly just have a look at which one I prefer here. So we've got ourselves. In fact, we'll probably have to move back here again. So we've got a few different options here, which I hope look as good as I had hoped they would look. Let's look there. So this one here has got the white bit at the top, which I actually do like quite a bit. That one there's got the oak at the top, which I also almost like more. I think I'm gonna go for oak at the top there, that's for sure. Let's actually just put some windows in these places. I can't bear to watch them without a window in them. So we just quickly go down here. I think I had some in one of these chests here. That chest there. There we go. Cool. All right, let's go put some windows in here. Now, quickly before I forget, I wanted to let you guys know that you guys who are new won't probably know this, but a large amount of you guys will, that next episode, which is episode 160, which it's pretty crazy that we're already at episode 160. It's pretty nuts. But yes, we are on episode 160 next episode. And really, if you guys didn't know, we do a world tour. And I enjoy those. I love doing the world tour. It's nice for me to reflect on what I've done. And it's also nice, you guys seem to enjoy it, to just kind of enjoy our place for what we've been working on it for. To just really, I mean, why do we build this world? Pretty much to enjoy working on it and enjoy walking through it once we've like ha seen our handiwork come into whatever we want it to be. So let's see that. Yeah, these definitely need work, that's for sure. You guys can let me know what you guys think about it. Please let me know. But yeah, guys, I think for today, that will do this episode. I'm actually probably going to go and record the next one straight away because I'm itching for it. I really feel like it. So that'll be all for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for all your suggestions in the past, actually, the past few videos. Thank you very, very much for that. But yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.